Hello, React Native developers. I hope you are well. William here, recording from beautiful Zurich, Switzerland. In this video, we're going to look at implementing blur gradients in React Native Skia. So in React Native Skia, we know how to do gradients very well. We know how to do blurs very well, but this is very tricky because we need to do a gradient blur. So it's a blur, but the intensity of the blur on each pixel is different depending on a pattern we are trying to achieve. So it can be a linear gradient, a linear mask, a radial gradient, any patterns you can imagine, any masks you can imagine. So here, I don't know if you can tell, but I'm using a radial gradient as a mask. So the top is blurred and the bottom also is blurred, but in like a circular way. And the problem is that we in Skia, we don't have a shader to, we can do a blur, but we don't have it exposed as a shader code that we can customize. So I looked at many blur algorithms. There are some which are of really good quality, but extremely slow. So the phone would blow up immediately. There are some which are extremely fast, but the quality is horrible. There are some which are really high quality and really fast, but they would be hard to customize. So we need to change the value on each pixel. And it would require quite a bit of work to make them work. So I looked at many blur shaders and shader toys. And this is the one that we're going to use. For an image, you see the quality is very good. It's very fast. And it would be easy to customize later with the blur amount. So first, let's convert it into a Skia shader. And what I like to do is to put it here into, first convert it into shaders, skia.org. And so let's have a look because it's very good. Like the error reporting is good. And so the main image becomes main. So the output, we return the color, so that's one of the difference. And here we can just have, this is the parameter we take as an input, the pixel coordinate. So here I can just return the color instead. So let's see which other things we need to change. So texture doesn't exist. So here it would be simply, so I channel zero, so as shader input, we have I image one, which we can use, and it's not texture, it would be eval. Okay, let's have a look. And yeah, this is not supported. And this needs to, in Skia shader language, this needs to be a const expression. So I can do const int or float actually, I think. Repeats equals 60. That looks good. You're like, no, that doesn't look good, but that looks good. Because so another big difference is that texture are coordinates from 0 to 1, but here we need the pixel. So for eval, so I can multiply by I resolution. So this should look good. Yes. So I resolution here for some reason is vector 3, so I can just do x, y to have vector 2, yes. And here I'm not sure why this is inverted. What if I do UV? So, I mean, but that's okay, right? This one we can remove. And blur amount, here it's updated with time, but we're gonna change its value based on like some linear mask. Okay, so guys, we have a shader right here. Boom. Yeah, not amazing quality, but for an image, I think fair enough. So I can paste the shader here and we need to apply it. So let's see. If I go, oops. So we have our blur gradient component. We pass the image as parameter, which we see here. So I think we just need to wrap it into another shader. So to have it as a child here, it will be bind to image one. So the source is this source, and uniforms, we need to pass the resolution. So uniforms high resolution with height. Resolution. Yeah, so now everything is blurred. So what we're going to do is to provide a mask. And we're going to use the alpha value of the mask to define the intensity of the blur. So for instance, we can do a linear gradient. That goes from, let's say we want to have the bottom blurred, so transparent, let's say transparent black. And we go from 0, 0 So now we have our mask. So if I go here, we can pass the mask also as a child of the shader. Okay, I don't know why I didn't like it, but so we have a second shader child, which we can call it mask. Okay, and now we can use the mask alpha value for the blur amount. So where is our blur amount? So here we're going to go from 0, so no blur, to 0, 1. And depending on the alpha value, so we're going to do mask eval at frag coordinate of A, let's say. Yeah. You see it, right? And what we can do, of course, is to overlay a scroll view on top. Right, so we can see the rubber band effect. So style, so we overlay on top of the Canva. We always overlay, right, the gestures on top of our Canva. Style sheet, absolute fill, scroll event throttle 16. And on scroll, we're going to add on scroll event from reanimated. So let's create a scroll Y value. Use animated scroll handler. That's good. How does it look like? I forgot. Where is the value? Can Copilot help me here? Let's see. No, okay. I'm not sure how the event is shaped, but we can do, is that a thing? Let's see. And then scroll Y, we can bind to the Y value of, let's see. No, that's not. Because also this needs to be animated. Yeah, that looks good, okay. Here would be minus. I like it. And one thing we can do, instead here of using, for instance, a linear gradient, we can use a radial gradient. So center would be width divided by 2, height divided by 2. Radius would be, I don't know, width divided by 2. And we would go from transparent to black. Maybe a bigger radius, even bigger. Something like, I mean, here it's way too big. Maybe transparent. Yeah, something like this. But this was way more complicated than I originally thought. When I saw the example, I thought I could just blur to the maximum value and mask with the non-blurred value. But that doesn't yield high quality results. And potentially we could take this feature much further, because we would have, we can take view, native view snapshots and use the blur on it. But the, here the blur quality of this shader is actually very low. So I think first we would need to spend some time to find a really high quality, really fast blur shader on for React Native Skia. I did find one using a two-pass blur, but I was not clear on how I could update the value of the amount of the blur on each pixel. So maybe a bit more research needs to be done here, but it was really fun to investigate how such an effect can be implemented. That's an effect that we are not really used to, right? It's not something that is available, I think, on Figma, or it's a really kind of a special effect, mixing the intensity of the blur with a mask. But I hope you enjoyed this example. Let me know your thoughts, and maybe if you have like some nice idea on how we could implement a really high quality, really fast blur gradient using React Native Skia. I am looking forward to talk to you soon, and until next time, happy hacking.